G proteins are extremely important for the signal transduction pathways. Generally, most membrane receptors, yes, so membrane receptors are those on the surface of the cellular membrane, are associated with the G proteins. Yes, so G proteins, not one G protein, but G proteins, they are different. Generally, these G proteins are related to the GDP. Yes, so G proteins will generally produce the GDP. And this ligand binding the membrane-bound receptor, G-protein complex, will cause phosphorylation of the GDP to the GTP. So the phosphorylation of the guanosine dephosphate, GTP, will generally, it's a generally production of the GTP, yes? So this is the GTP, yes? We have some receptor is getting activated, receptor gets activated, and it produces the GTP. Simple like that. What does it mean it produces GTP from GDP that is freely flowing somewhere in the cell. Yes. So the G protein is able to produce GTP from GDP when the receptor would get activated. So for example, adenosine cyclase phosphorylation. Allowing the interaction with activating membrane-bound enzyme. For example, adenosine cyclase phosphorylase C. So this GTP may activate further things. Yes, or the G protein may be activating further things on its own. Yes, so it's this GTP can start some cascade. Yes, this domino effect. That I pointed out earlier. Yes, so one passes to the other, one passes to the other, one passes to the other. GTP is still not the target substance. Yes, the target is some action. Yes, so for example, production of some proteins. Yes, but the GTP is one more step in this domino effect in order to get what we want. Okay. And of course, the second messengers can be also the protein kinases, yes, of different types. The activated G proteins also have a guanine GTP activates to inactivate the process. In the case of adenyl cyclase, the G phase produced by GTP and the presence of GTP on the subunit will cause G alpha to bind to the subunits, thereby resulting in activation of adenyl cyclase. This is important because we generally have two substances that are a bit acting in an opposite way. Yes, we have the ATP, CEMP, maybe better, and GTP. GTP and ATP can get to the GTP to the cyclic and to the cyclic AMP. So those substances, yes, so related to the phosphorylated guanosine and phosphorylated adenine, works in a bit opposite way. I suppose it would be best if you get here, yes. So we can have some G proteins that acts on the adenyl cyclase and that would produce the CAMP, yes. This is also possible. Some other G proteins would create the cyclic GEMP. Yes, GEMP and CIMP works generally in opposite way, usually on the cell. This CIMP, for example, can activate some protein kinases. GEMP also, cyclic GEMP can also activate some protein kinases, and so on. The G protein can be also coupled to the phospholipase C and produces the IP3. Yes, so inosinophilic phosphate, generally speaking. So critical thing to remember is that we have the receptor. Receptor gets activated. It activates the G protein, and then G protein can activate different things. Yes, it can be adenyl cyclase. It can be guanyl cyclase. Yes, it can be phospholipase C. All of those enzymes will lead to different actions in the cell. Yes, so activation of the receptor, G protein would pass information to adenyl cyclase, phospholipase C, or guanyl cyclase, or something else. Yes, We are passing the information, we are getting this domino effect. This domino effect is the most important thing to remember about this single transduction.